Hey guys, this is a basic tutorial for how I handle vectorizing fonts that I don't have. So I got this file today. It is raster. You can see all the pixels in it, nasty. And my client has asked me to vectorize this. Well, I immediately recognized the font below group as Futura. It's a very recognizable common font. This one I was not as familiar with. It looks similar to a lot of things. But, you know, the stuff I had, the S was different, or the M was maybe a little different, or something, you know. And so I'm like, I really don't want to do this by hand, and I like to have fonts. In case I see this font again, I can easily just type it out. So if you don't know what the font is, and you have a file like this that's, you know, you can easily see that the letters are all readable, well, then you can bring this into Photoshop and crop out what you need. So I've already done it. Originally, it looked like this. And I went ahead and just cropped Davis. I think that's probably going to give me a better sampling than if I have the M in there, because the M's bigger and it might throw things off. So I'm going to do just Davis. And I saved that as a JPEG. I just save it WTF.jpg. So then you come to www.myfonts.com/what-the-font. What the font. See? So take the image that you created, choose a file, WTF.jpg, perfect. You come over here to continue. And you'll see what it does is it shows you the image you uploaded here. This is each individual letter that it can distinguish from your file. If they're touching each other, say if the A was touching the D, it would not be able to tell that this is a D and an A. It would screw up and probably say, oh, it's a W or something weird like that. So sometimes you have to go in and like, create some space in your Photoshop file, actually like pull these letters apart if you want to do this method. But most of the time you can do it this way. Now, as you can see, it got most things right. It's like DAVI5, okay, it's close, but the A is lowercase. We want to actually make that uppercase. The V is lowercase, and I'm going to get uppercase. The I is perfect, D is perfect, and that is obviously an S, not a 5. So this makes me think it's probably not going to get it correct. But let's see. Continue. Oh, how those grotesque bolds. Really close, but no, that S is not right. And I would think that maybe that A might not be correct, too. There might be a little bit different spacing of, but who knows? It's hard to tell. Hard to tell at that size. But I want to get it right on. So let's say none of these match, then they don't. But let's say I couldn't even work with them. I don't want to work with them. What would you do next? After that, if there's no good match, you just click here on Consult an Expert. This will create a case file. You know, normally I just name it Davis. Boom. And here's the image that you're putting in there. Any additional information. Notify me. Make sure this is checked so you can get an email that's saying somebody went in. I did this already, and in about 2 minutes, somebody got back with me and told me that it was Motor Oil 1937, something from defont.com. I've never seen this font before, never used it before. Downloaded it, and it's a perfect match. So if I just type this out, D-A-V-I-S, you can see, perfect match. Now, I will have to come in here and tweak a little bit, because you can see the A is a little bit taller, the V is a little bit lower, but the rest of this is going to look just fine. I think maybe even if I bumped it up just one point, you'll see that that's going to be a perfect match. And that's just much easier now that I have this font. I can tweak things, you know, way quicker. I can just like bring in the kerning a little bit. I can drop the font size on the A a little bit, which probably needs to be about right there. And then maybe scoot it over. I could probably tweak it a little better if I open up this. But you get the idea. Much easier to deal with than if I had to make everything by hand. And now I've got this font for future reference if I ever see it again. So that's my quick and dirty on how to get fonts that you don't have and identify them.